Hidden in the forest southeast of Mount St. Helens are a series of lava tubes, shield volcanoes, volcanic features which formed under a thick glacier, and a singular young lava flow of a very large size which covers approximately 19.5 square miles. All of these features and more are part of a technically still active volcanic complex which is frequently overlooked by the two towering stratovolcanoes to its north, being known as the Indian Heaven Volcanic Field. The Indian Heaven Volcanic Field can be found in south-central Washington State, where it is just north of the Columbia River, with the nearest community being the town of Stabler, 10 miles to the southwest. The Indian Heaven Volcanic Field consists of approximately 70 vents spread across an area of 450 square kilometers. These consist of cinder cones, shield volcanoes, toyas, and a singular mare composed of low silica eruptive products that, although primarily composed of basalt, also on occasion contain basaltic andesite and andesite. Most of these vents are aligned along a single north-northeast facing line, which is 17 miles in length. These vents all formed in moderately explosive eruptions, with the story of this field beginning approximately 700,000 years ago. That means that Indian Heaven was erupting long before Mount St. Helens existed, or even before Mount Adams began to grow. So, 700,000 years ago, magma with an initially low silica composition was generated from the subduction of the one-day Fuca plate underneath the North American tectonic plate. This magma quickly intruded into the crust, eventually rising to just below the surface, causing an explosive reaction which expelled volcanic projectiles and created an ash-dense plume. As the magma continued upwards, the gases and volatile material within it quickly expanded, propelling the magma upwards until a several hundred foot high lava fountain was generated. This eruption slowly but surely built an 800 foot tall cinder cone which produced blocky lava flows that moved towards the southeast. By the time this eruption had ended, the feature that we today know as Flat Top Mountain had been constructed. I cannot prove the following statement, but I have a suspicion that no further eruptions occurred in this part of the field because its magma was partially stolen deep underground and redirected into the underlying system that would form Mount Adams. Subsequent eruptions occurred about once every 10,000 years, primarily occurring in a dominant zone of weakness in the crust that had developed. Several 5-mile-wide shield volcanoes formed, including Red Mountain, so named because of the bright red scoria on its peaks which became visible after glaciation greatly smoothed its edifice. At least 7 major glaciations would occur across the lifetime of this field, and since the ice sheet at times was up to 500 meters or 1640 feet thick, means that interesting lava-ice interactions occurred. As lava erupted into the bottom of this glacier, it could not travel very far and slowly built up into a steep-sided hill. Eventually, a large section of the overlying glacier was melted by its proximity to the lava, forming a small glacial lake. As eruptive activity continued, the volcanic cone eventually reached the height of the lake. Lavas then slowly deposited along the level of the lake water, forming a flat top. By the time the eruptive series had ended 130,000 years ago, what remained was a unique subglacial volcano termed a toya, today known as Lone Butte. During the last 30,000 years, this field was more active than average, producing 6 distinct eruptions. The youngest of these occurred in 6150 BCE, where 900 million cubic meters of lava was erupted from a central cinder cone over a period of 200 days. The deposit it formed is today known as the Big Lava Flow and is easily visible from satellite. While this volcanic field is unlikely to erupt anytime soon, a future eruption could generate minor disruptions to air traffic through Strombolian-associated ash emissions alongside lava flows potentially up to 29 miles in length. As a result of these hazards, the US Geological Survey designated Indian Heaven as a low-threat volcano.